Good afternoon. The Princess of Wales is pleading for privacy and time to recover after her bombshell cancer announcement. Following weeks of intense speculation, Catherine released a video message from her home in Windsor, revealing she's in the fight of her life. Here's Edward Godfrey.
Conspiracy theorists and the rumour mill have been in overdrive since the last time the Princess of Wales was seen. Now we have the facts bravely laid bare by the Princess herself, telling the world she is receiving cancer treatment. It was detected after she'd gone into hospital for that abdominal surgery in January. Tests done during that procedure later revealing the cancer was present and her medical team advising that she undergoes preventative chemotherapy, which she's in the early stages of. In a video message recorded at her home, she says it came as a huge shock and the last couple of months have been extremely difficult for the entire family. One of the biggest challenges has been explaining the situation to the three children, George, Charlotte and Louis, trying to reassure them that she's going to be okay. She says she tells them that she's well and she's getting stronger.
This, of course, came as a huge shock. And William and I have been doing everything we can to process and manage this privately for the sake of our young family. As you can imagine, this has taken time. It has taken me time to recover from major surgery in order to start my treatment. But most importantly, it has taken us time to explain everything to George, Charlotte and Louis in a way that's appropriate for them and to reassure them that I'm going to be okay.
It's been an extraordinary year for the royal family. The princess was last seen at Sandringham on Christmas Day with the rest of the family. A few weeks after that, it was announced she'd gone into the London clinic for that abdominal surgery and would be there for a couple of weeks and then taking time away from public duties until after Easter. Reaction to the princess's message about her cancer diagnosis has been enormous from right around the world and from close by, from the king, who's been in close contact with the princess over the last few weeks following their time in hospital together, has said he's so proud of Catherine for her courage in speaking as she did and referred to her as the monarch's beloved daughter-in-law. There was also a brief statement from Harry and Meghan saying, "We wish health and healing for Kate and the family and hope they're able to do so privately and in peace." The Princess of Wales has asked for privacy and for time as she focuses now on making a full recovery.
There have been violent scenes in Melbourne as anti-trans demonstrators clashed with police and counter-protesters on Spring Street. Officers used capsicum spray when activists tried to break through a police line. Emily Rice was there.
There was a huge police presence outside of State Parliament for the gender-related protest.
The rally was organised by feminist group Women Will Speak, who are protesting the perceived erosion of their rights by non-biological females, known more commonly as transgender individuals. Also present, counter-organisations from the queer and trans community campaigning for their rights. A group of self-proclaimed freedom fighters were also amid the fray. The increasing antagonism soon escalated to a physical fracas. A Herald Sun photographer knocked and injured in the chaos.
It just happened so fast.
Later, more scuffles as the demonstrators took their issues out on each other. A huge police force was there every step of the way. This rally in Melbourne is one of many being held internationally recently as the debate over gender politics heats up.
Three people have been killed in a fiery crash at Maryborough, north of Brisbane. Two semi-trailers were among five vehicles involved in the late-night disaster, as Jacob Chico explains.
It's a confronting scene here on the Bruce Highway, and this morning, confirmation from police at least three people have died following this awful five-vehicle crash in Maryborough last night.
It was around 9:50 when investigators say a driver in an SUV failed to give way when turning right onto the Bruce Highway, colliding with a semi-trailer, causing it to crash into another semi in the northbound lane. Three men in those vehicles were given no chance when a fiery inferno erupted after the impact.
The disaster victim identification unit only comes to scenes like aeroplane crashes. So I think that gives you a clear picture of the scene that they were confronted with.
A man and woman from the Northern Territory and a 50-year-old man from Townsville are lucky to be alive, with their vehicles also involved in the accident. They walked away with just minor injuries, while three other families now are coming to terms with the loss of their loved ones.
Unfortunately, because we've had to bring the disaster victim identification squad in, we are not ruling out that there could be more than three people dead as a result of this crash.
The section of the Bruce Highway remained closed today as emergency services combed the scene. Police say the investigation could take weeks and will conduct tests now to determine whether alcohol or drugs played a factor.
Economists are warning there'll be no relief for household budgets for some time to come. The Reserve Bank has flagged borrowers will face tough conditions for the rest of the year before the strain starts to ease. Claudia Vrajoljak reports.
Economists say Australian households could face even more pressure over the next 6 months, forcing more to cut back on spending and even sell off their homes if we don't see interest rate cuts. Around 5% of mortgage borrowers are currently spending more than they earn on essential living costs and their repayments, according to the Reserve Bank's latest half-yearly financial stability review. 1 in 20 are struggling to repay their mortgage, but the rest are finding ways to make ends meet, while overwhelmingly most are managing the tough economic conditions thanks to strong jobs and drawing on savings. The RBA warns it will remain a challenging year ahead for many.
Well, overall, the Reserve Bank is painting a fairly benign picture of the state of Australian households, despite the big rise in interest rates. But there is a bit of a sting in the tail. It estimates that around 5% of households are cash flow negative, and that number will remain around these levels for most of the rest of this year until some relief kicks in next year.
With unemployment down and interest rate cut anytime soon is less likely, and there's growing calls for the federal government to introduce more cost of living measures, which we are likely to see in the May budget before changes to stage three tax cuts roll out from July.
More than 130,000 fans have flooded through the gates at the Australian Grand Prix. It's the event's biggest Saturday on record, as Australian hope Oscar Piastri drew the faithful. Amber Johnston is there.
It is Oscar mania down here today, with a sea of McLaren orange flooding Albert Park for day two of racing. What do we think, guys? It was a mad dash to the Melbourne Walk for hundreds of McLaren fans fighting for pole position to catch a glimpse of the Australian prodigy. From a fresh-faced rookie to Australia's best Formula One hope. The competition to get a signature almost as fierce as the battle on track.
How did you manage that?
With the help of everybody up at the front, it's a community here, so everybody's just handing stuff forward and getting everything signed.
Before the drivers hit the Albert Park circuit, they hit the fan zone. Ferrari's Carlos Sainz addressing concerns about his health.
And already being here is a bit of a win.
While Haas's Kevin Magnussen was given a lesson in good old Aussie culture by Josh Dacos.
I'll get Josh to show you how.
Seven-time world champion Lewis Hamilton more worried about the Australian wildlife.
Every time I get here, I check under my toilet seat. I check in my shoes. I put my shoes up on the side. When I put my helmet on yesterday, I was like looking inside. I don't mess with spiders, you know.
It is the first time in Australian Grand Prix history that all three race days have sold out. And you can feel it down here at Albert Park today. It is just so busy with so many fans. And today is already shaping up to be another record-breaking crowd.